Hey folks, Bernie Arneson with Telecompetitor and Pivot, talking today with Tim Ludwar of SaskTel, who's sharing some great insight into the major fiber expansion project they have going on in Saskatchewan. So, Tim, talk about some of the key goals in the execution of this fiber expansion. What was a key objective?
SaskTel understands the importance of providing broadband to our customers, no matter where they reside. And building a fiber network is the best platform to fulfill the needs for today and well into the future. This is this and the ability to deploy timely and efficient are key. Most of the industry understands to design, make ready, and build a fiber network takes a large capital investment, which needs to be economically viable. When SaskTel approved the Fiber to the Community program, we took the opportunity to review our entire build process, knowing that the small communities may not be 100% like large urban centers. We set ourselves a goal to obtain a 30% savings. This would mean we would be able to even build more communities and reach more customers if we could accomplish this.
Wow, a goal of a 30% cost reduction. I imagine that is no easy task to accomplish. 30% is a lot. What were some guiding principles for you to keep you on track towards that ambitious goal?
In order to ensure we didn't compromise, you know, what is most important to SaskTel and our customers, we established 10 guiding principles that each of our re-engineering ideas had to pass through. Things like aligning to our corporate values and our business code of ethics. We have a broadband strategy, you know, providing exceptional customer experience, building low-touch networks that can be and support flexibility, minimizing operations costs for the life of the network, accelerating speed to revenue, reduce the cost of materials, warehousing, training, and tools are just some of them.
So I understand that Corning is a key supplier for you. How have they helped you achieve this important goal?
SaskTel and Corning have a very long relationship in this industry. And I don't view Corning as a supplier. I view them as a partner, as I do all of our vendors. This partnership relationship fosters mindset professionals, you know, like Barry Walton and Martin Gagne and Nick Gargliano. So when I proposed this re-engineering idea past them, they were all in, assisting with the facilitation, offering up their experiences and some of their contacts in the industry, providing product ideas and solutions which align to our goal.
So you're about two-thirds into this project by my math. Do you feel good about where you are, and are there any key lessons learned to share?
I do feel good about where we are, especially with the redesign activities. We came up with 23 ideas that passed the guiding principles tests. We have incorporated 9 of those ideas into our build process, and we're seeing economic benefits. Some of the lessons learned, collaboration is key. Second, we use the design thinking method by breaking down each element of the activity and building and of the build, providing the opportunity to take a fresh look at the process. What is being done for whom, the material we're using, and the best methods. At SaskTel, we pride ourselves at being a company who lives and breathes transformation. This activity provided us the opportunity to exercise this.
Awesome. Thank you, Tim. And that concludes part 2 of our discussion with Tim at SaskTel. Please stay tuned to part 3.